Cardano is without a doubt one of the most interesting cryptocurrency projects in the market today. Bitcoin gave us decentralized payments, Ethereum gave us smart contracts, and Cardano aims to improve upon the cryptocurrencies that came before it. Here's how. Cardano is a third generation decentralized blockchain-based system powered by the ADA coin, the cryptocurrency which runs on the Cardano platform. It borrows elements from and improves upon the cryptocurrencies that came before it, notably Bitcoin and Ethereum. Much like Ethereum, it is a smart contract-based system that can be used to run decentralized applications, but in a much more efficient way. The first generation started with Bitcoin. Bitcoin was created because everyone was asking the same question: is it possible to create decentralized money, a digital asset that you can send and receive that is scarce and tradable without any third party involved? Satoshi Nakamoto answered these questions when he created Bitcoin. We finally had a decentralized monetary system which can transfer money from one person to another. However, there was a problem with Bitcoin, which is a problem with all first generation blockchains. They only allowed for monetary transactions. There was no way to add conditions to those transactions. These conditions would need extremely complicated programming. Something was required to make the process more seamless. That's where the second generation comes in. It brought a programming language to the blockchain, and suddenly money was programmable and smart contracts were born. Smart contracts help you exchange money, property, shares, or anything of value in a transparent, conflict-free way while avoiding the services of a middleman. Vitalik Buterin's Ethereum is the clear standout of this generation. Ethereum showed the world how blockchain can evolve from a simple payment system to something far more powerful. Ethereum was created with the very serious purpose of revolutionizing the financial system with smart contract technology. However, this generation had its own issues, as it didn't have a good response to scalability. The first decentralized application to go viral and capture the imagination of the Ethereum network participants was the collectible token known as CryptoKitties. During the bull market of 2017, CryptoKitties caught fire with more than $2 million worth of daily volume traded at the height of the kitty mania. At that point, CryptoKitties were responsible for 12% of all Ethereum transactions and single-handedly managed to put the entire Ethereum network to a screeching halt, further highlighting the scalability bottleneck of current platforms. Additionally, the governance system of these blockchains were not really that well thought out. A good example being the Ethereum and Ethereum Classic split, followed by Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash, and most recently the controversial hash war-induced Bitcoin Cash and Bitcoin SV hard fork is a classic example of bad governance. This is where the third generation comes in. By combining the positive elements from the first two generations of blockchain, what came out as a result was Cardano. The three elements that Cardano wanted to solve were scalability, interoperability, and sustainability. What really sets Cardano apart from the competition is the process by which it is being developed. With more than 2,000 cryptocurrencies in existence and new ones popping up all the time, it's hard to stand out. But Cardano has many advantages over rival coins. So many that it appears destined to be one of the most dominant cryptocurrencies over the long term. You might be surprised to know that the brains behind Cardano is one of the co-founders of Ethereum, Charles Hoskinson.
The initial design brief was, could you build a Japanese version of Ethereum? Since we realized that we could create something that was an intersection of commerce, computation, and compliance. You can use it on a cell phone, it's very natural, it's very easy, and it's actually a better experience than somebody would encounter with PayPal or a credit card. We wanted to iterate and evolve the Ethereum model as well as explore adding new cryptographic techniques.
What really makes Cardano remarkable is the sheer amount of care that goes into its upkeep. There are three organizations which work full-time to develop and take care of Cardano. The Cardano Foundation is a not-for-profit regulated entity. Their main function is to standardize, protect, and promote the Cardano protocol technology. IOHK, is a software research and development company. They have been contracted to build, design, and maintain Cardano until 2020. Finally, we have Emergo. Emergo is a Japanese company that develops, supports, and incubates commercial ventures who want to revolutionize their industries using blockchain technology. Much of IOHK's funding comes from a 5-year contract with Emergo. These three organizations work in synergy to make sure that Cardano development is going on at a good pace. Unlike most cryptocurrencies, Cardano didn't start as a white paper. Instead, the project started as a set of design principles, engineering best practices, and avenues for exploration. The code that resulted from the team's research was made open source and subject to peer review, just as with any serious scientific endeavor. That's unheard of among cryptocurrencies, which too often consist of code copied from other coins by a handful of anonymous developers. Cardano's code, by contrast, was built completely from scratch. It's built in a programming language called Haskell, an advanced system in which code can be written more precisely, reducing errors and making the platform more secure. ADA is the digital currency which fuels the Cardano platform. Its primary motive is to provide quick and safe currency exchange and allow users to operate various smart contracts and applications seamlessly. Cardano uses proof of stake, in which holding ADA tokens gives you a stake in the network, and the stakeholders receive rewards for validating the blocks and securing the network. Cardano hopes to achieve sustainability by using an innovative version of the proof-of-stake consensus mechanism called Ouroboros. This is a crucial part of the infrastructure that supports the ADA cryptocurrency and is a major innovation in blockchain technology. Ouroboros eliminates the need for an energy-hungry proof-of-work protocol, which stands as a barrier to blockchain scaling up for much wider use. Ouroboros is the first proof-of-stake protocol that has mathematically been shown to be provably secure. The level of security demonstrated by Ouroboros compares to that of Bitcoin's blockchain, which has never been compromised. One way Cardano improves on cryptocurrency design is by separating its two main functions into two distinct layers, one for the transfer of value and one for the storage of data. Limiting the duties of the settlement layer makes it more secure and preserves privacy for basic transactions that don't require metadata. Having a separate control layer is better for Cardano as a platform. It's used for smart contracts, decentralized applications, and even as a foundation for initial coin offerings. It allows the control layer to be optimized for these uses, while Ethereum's single layer system must do double duty. Best of all, the two-layer design means each layer can be upgraded separately as needed in the way of soft forks. As Cardano executes on its roadmap, the platform will gradually add new features. According to the roadmap, Cardano will be released in 5 phases. Byron was all about creating a bulletproof foundation. It's the first layer of the Cardano platform and the heart of the system, aka the Cardano settlement layer. It allows users to send and receive ADA tokens. Shelley is focused on turning Cardano into a fully decentralized and autonomous system, starting with staking, stake pools, and delegation. Gauguin brings different computation layers that enable smart contracts for financial transactions such as hedging, fixed-term deposits, credit swaps, crowdfunding, as well as complex decentralized applications. The features in Basho are focused on performance and scalability. Similar to BitTorrent, the system will gain more resources with every new user. Voltaire is focused on sustainability and self-sovereign identity. There will be a treasury model and a mechanism to contribute to Cardano via improvement proposals. One interesting aspect of the Cardano project is quantum-resistant signatures. This will protect funds held on the Cardano blockchain from being compromised using quantum computers. Quantum computers are a major existential threat to cryptocurrencies. That's because they have the capacity to break the cryptographic algorithms that that are used in blockchain. They never really get much attention in the crypto sphere because it is widely assumed that the quantum technology is still far off. However, these computers may actually be a reality sooner than most people think. In fact, the quantum resistance signatures aspect of the Cardano project could actually end up being its biggest strength going forward. First, it could become the backbone that aids in the adoption of Cardano by institutional investors. That's because for institutional investors looking to put money in crypto, security is an absolute concern. With quantum resistance, businesses should also be more confident in developing their systems on the Cardano blockchain. That's because it offers an element of long-term sustainability. In a few years, quantum resistance could very well be a key issue, and on this basis alone, businesses, especially those dealing with sensitive data, can leverage the Cardano blockchain. Cardano is the first blockchain project to be developed from a scientific philosophy and the only one to be designed and built by a global team of leading academics and engineers. Cardano is secure, flexible, and scalable for use by millions of users and has been developed with the same scientific rigor applied to mission-critical systems such as aerospace and banking. A major innovation of Cardano is that it will balance the needs of users with those of regulators, and in doing so, combine privacy with regulation. The vision of Cardano is that its new style of regulated computing will bring greater financial inclusion by providing open access for all to fair financial services. If you made it to the end of this video, let me know in the comments if you're bullish or bearish on Cardano in 2019. Also, make sure you subscribe and like this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later.